Hello everyone, this is Nitish and we have started an initiative called Plum Series, which is Prelims Level Up MCQ Series. Here we discuss 5 MCQs daily and this will help you in your UPSC preparation. Today is episode number 130 and I am dealing with Economics MCQ. Before starting this class, I would like you to please subscribe the channel and also like and comment on videos. These contents are free of cost, so for test series and foundation video, you can contact to White Sir on WhatsApp 7200-681-675. So let's begin. Today's MCQ number 1 is, with reference to priority sector lending directions issued by RBI, consider the following statements. Statement number 1. It is applicable to only those foreign banks which have more than 20 bank branches functioning in India. Statement number 2 is, the compliance of banks to the targets is monitored on quarterly basis. Statement number 3. A regional rural bank has to ensure that more than 50% of its net credit goes to PSL, that is priority sector lending. And statement number 4 is, if a scheduled commercial bank does not fulfill its target, then it has to contribute the remaining target in rural infrastructure development fund. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding PSL, that is priority sector lending. Option A, 1, 2 and 4 only, 2, 3 and 4 only, 1, 2 and 3 only, and last is 3 and 4 only. I will provide you 10 seconds, try to answer this question. So its answer will be option number B, which means that statement number 2, 3 and 4 are the correct statement. Now let's look at the explanation. First we know what is priority sector. Priority sector are basically those sectors which the Government of India and Reserve Bank of India considered as important sector for the development of basic need of the country and are to be given priority over the other sector. So the details regarding priority sector are mentioned in the statement itself. So we discuss one statement one by one. Statement number 1 is incorrect because the PSL directions are applicable to all foreign banks, but here we can see that it is put some condition regarding foreign banks, that only those foreign banks are applicable which have more than 20 bank branches functioning in India. But it is an incorrect statement because it is applicable to all foreign banks. Statement number 2 is correct because monitoring of priority sector lending target is done on quarterly basis in order to ensure continuous flow of credit to priority sector, which is statement number 2. Statement number 3 is also correct because regional rural banks and small finance banks are mandated to lend 75% of adjusted net bank credit or CEOBE, whichever is higher, as total priority sector lending. Statement number 4 is also correct because in case of non-achievement of priority sector targets by commercial bank, the same amount shall be allocated for contribution to rural infrastructure development fund established with NABARD and other funds with NABARD, NHB, SIDBI, MUDRA, as decided by Reserve Bank from time to time. That's why statement number 2 and statement number 3 are also the correct statement. That's why the option number B is the correct. MCQ number 2. Which one of the following is the correct description of the term special provisioning of loan? Which means that you have an idea about special provisioning of loan. Statement A. It means keeping a part of fund available with the bank for expanding its business. Statement number B. It is a practice of keeping an amount of money available for lending to a particular sector. Statement C. It refers to reserving a part of fund available for financial management during economic crisis. And statement number D. It refers to keeping an amount of money available to be used in case of a possible future loss or NPA. So I will provide you 10 seconds. Try to answer this question and write it in the comment section. So its correct answer will be option number D, which means that special provisioning of loans means it refers to keeping an amount of money available to be used in case of a possible future loss or NPA. So now let's look at the explanation. That is, special provisioning of loan is one of the mechanisms designed by Reserve Bank of India to tackle the NPA or bad asset problem in the banking sector. It is an important part of RBI's prudential regulation. Under provisioning, banks have to set aside funds or provide funds to a prescribed percentage of their bad assets. The percentage of bad asset that has to be provided for is called provisioning coverage ratio. So here you have you understand two concepts, that is a special provisioning of loan, and second is provisioning coverage ratio, that is the percentage of bad asset that will be to, that is to be provided for, is called provisioning coverage ratio. Now MCQ number 3 is, Ministry of Electronics and IT, that is Information Technology, has launched the country's first QSIM toolkit. In this context, which one of the following statement correctly describe QSIM toolkit? This question is basically contemporary affairs, so please try to answer this question. Statement A. It is a form of qualified guidelines for regulating the social media algorithm of search result on their platform. Statement B. It enables researchers and students to carry out research in quantum computing in a cost-effective manner. Statement C. It is a quotient simulator designed for upgrading the inter-ministerial communication software. And statement number D is, it is a reference framework that aims to provide information regarding emergent technologies and their application. So, I will provide you 10 seconds. Try to answer this question. So its correct answer will be option number B, that is the QSIM toolkit is basically, it enables researchers and students to carry out research in quantum computing in a cost-effective manner. Now let's look at the explanation, which is the same, that is the QSIM is first of its kind toolkit that enables researchers and students to carry out research in quantum computing in a cost-effective manner. So here you need to know that is QSIM is built by Indian Institute of Science Bangalore, Indian Institute of Technology Roorkee and Center for Development of Advanced Computing, that is CDAC. So this point is also very important regarding QSIM. Now MCQ number 4. With reference to monetary policy of India, why consumer price index was chosen as measure for flexible inflation targeting in India? Statement 1. It reflects the cost of living. Statement 2. It is used as a reference in wage contract. Statement 3. It includes food and fuel. Statement 4. It gives a picture of prices of goods before the retail level. So you have to identify the correct statement. Option A, 1, 2 and 3 only, 2, 3 and 4 only, 1, 3 and 4 only, and D is 1, 2 and 4 only. I will provide you 10 seconds. Try to answer this question. So its correct answer will be option A, which means that 1, 2 and 3 are the correct statement. So now let's look at the explanation. Statement 1 is correct because CPI measures the inflation at which consumer buy goods and services. Therefore, it closely reflects the cost of living and influences inflation expectations related to other available metrics. That's why the statement number 1 is correct. Statement 2 is also correct because it is used as a reference in wage contract and negotiations. Therefore, it can also be easily understood. That's why statement 2 is correct. Statement 3. Headline inflation was preferred over core inflation. It includes food and fuel comprise, which constitutes more than 50% of consumption basket and which cannot be discarded. That is statement number 3. Now, statement number 4 is incorrect because it basically deals with wholesale price index. That is the statement number 4, because in wholesale price index gives the picture of price of goods before the retail level. That's why statement number 4 is the incorrect one. Now, last MCQ of today's class. Consider the following statement regarding trademark. A trademark is a symbol, design, word or phrase that is identified with a business. When a trademark is registered, its owner can claim exclusive right on its use. Statement 3 is, a trademark is valid indefinitely without any renewal. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding trademark. Option A, 1 only, 1 and 2 only, 1 and 3 only, and 1, 2 and 3, that is all of the above. So I will provide you 10 seconds, try to answer this question. So its correct answer will be option number B, which means that statement number 1 and statement number 2 are correct regarding trademark. So a trademark is a symbol, design, word or phrase that is identified with a business. When a trademark is registered, its owner can claim exclusive right on its use, which is statement number 1 and statement number 2. Now let's look at statement number 3, why it is incorrect. A trademark is valid for 10 years, but here it is written that a trademark is valid indefinitely without any renewal. That's why the statement number 3 is incorrect one. A trademark is valid for 10 years and can be renewed by the owner indefinitely every 10 years. So that's all for today's class. Next episode will be tomorrow. So please subscribe and stay tuned.